Buzz, buzz, once there was a little boy, and his name was John. John couldn't do anything right. Whenever John played baseball, he always made the first out. Whenever John played tag, he was always it. Whenever John played hide-and-seek, he was always the first one found. John couldn't do anything right. Well, it was summertime, you see. School had just closed. It was the beginning of summer vacation. And John was sitting on his porch with his friends. They were sitting on the steps and on the railings and on the lawn. And you know what the boys and girls say. As soon as school closes, the first thing they say, "There's nothing to do. It's boring. There's nothing to do." And John, he was kind of bored, you know. He didn't want to play baseball. He'd make the first out. Or tag, he'd be it. Hide and seek, he'd be found. So John thought he'd run away from home. So John, he ran across the street and down the street into a field. And then John thought he'd rest for a little while and run further away later. So John sat down on the grass and he leaned up against a tree. And that summer sun was shining on John's face and it lulled John to sleep. And as John was sleeping, a little snail with a silver shell crawled across the grass. And that snail with the silver shell crawled up John's arm and over John's shoulder. And that snail with the silver shell crawled up to John's neck. And that snail with the silver shell crawled up to John's ear. And that snail with the silver shell said, "John, I know you, John. You're a good boy. You just can't do anything right. But John, I'm going to tell you 100 stories that no one else has ever heard, John. And John, you can share those stories with your friends." And that snail with the silver shell told John 100 stories that no one else had ever heard. And as John was laying in that field, a bumblebee flew right by John's ear and went, "Buzz, buzz, once there was..." And John opened his eyes just in time to hear his mother's voice come floating by. "John! John!" It was supper time. John forgot all about running away from home. John went back home. He had a nice big supper. And after supper, John sat on the steps and his friends came over. And they sat on the railings and on the porch and on the lawn. And you know what they say in the summertime. "There's nothing to do. It's boring. There's nothing to do." And John said, I could tell you a story." "What, John?" "I said, I could tell you a story." "Hey, John's going to tell us a story. Go ahead, John. We're listening." "Go ahead, John." And John told them a story and they said, "Wow, John, that was really good. Do you know another one?" And John told him another story and he said, "John, that was awesome. Do you know any more?" "John, that was far out. Do you know any more?" And John told story after story after story. And it started getting late and the sun went down and the moon came out and the stars came out and their parents came out looking for them. And they sat down and listened to John tell stories too until the mosquitoes came out. Then they all went home. But the next morning, all John's friends came back. And John told stories all that day, and the following day, and the day after that, and all that week, and the following week. John told story after story after story. And then one day, John started to tell a story when a little girl raised her hand. She said, "Excuse me, John, but you already told us that story. Don't you know any others?" John said, "No, I don't know any other stories. I told you all the stories that I know. I don't know any other stories. You don't know any other stories? John is boring. John is boring. John felt terrible. John thought he'd run away from home, go find that snail with the silver shell. So John, he ran down the street into that field. He was looking everywhere for that snail. He looked in the bushes. He looked under logs. Oh, he looked up in the trees. He was looking everywhere. And then John thought what he'd do is rest for a little while and see if he could find that snail later. So John, he sat down on the ground. He leaned up against a tree. And that summer sun was shining on John's face. He got a little tired, and he put his hand down on the ground, and it landed on a flat rock. And John thought, maybe the snail with the silver shell lives under this rock. So John picked up that rock, and right there stood a witch about the size of a gummy bear. She looked up at John and said, what do you want, John? Can't you see I'm teaching magic tricks to all the worms? I'm teaching to dig holes in the ground and come up with little pebbles. What do you want, John? I'm sorry, but do you know where the snail with the silver shell lives? John, you'll never find that snail. He lives way over there. Thank you. Close the door. Okay. Yee. And John put the rock back down on the ground, and John ran across the field until he found himself in a field full of mushrooms. They were tall mushrooms. They were taller than John. And then he saw a little old man sitting on a tree stump. The little old man had a long gray beard, had on Oshkosh jeans and Reeboks. Excuse me, sir, but do you know where the snail with the silver shell lives?
The snail with the silver shell? I know that snail, young man. He told me 100 stories. But I didn't have anybody to share those stories with. And they all turned into mushrooms.
I'm sorry about that, but do you know where he lives?
Who?
The snail with the silver shell.
John, you might as well give up. You'll never find that snail. That snail lives way over there.
Thank you. And John ran through that field full of mushrooms until he found himself in a forest. And he started to walk through that forest when he heard something climbing a tree. And he looked up, and there was a great big brown bear climbing the tree. And John said, excuse me, Mr. Bear, do you know where the snail with the silver shell lives? And the bear looked down at John and said, John, how can you ask me a question like that now? Can't you see I'm busy climbing this tree? I'm trying to get the moon out the sky, John. It's always messing with my sleep at night. What did you ask me?
The snail with the silver shell. Do you know where he lives?
John, you might as well give up. You'll never find that snail. That snail lives way over there.
Thank you.
And John ran through that forest until he came to a beach. And the waves are coming in and splashing on the sand and going back out. And splashing and going back out. And John looked, and he saw on the surface of the water, he saw a whale. And on the whale's back, he saw a dozen mermaids. And they had long hair. And some had black hair. And some had red hair. And some had brown hair. And some had blonde hair. And they were braiding each other's hair. And John said, excuse me, mermaids, do you know where the snail with the silver shell lives? And the mermaids looked at John and said, John, before you find the snail with the silver shell, you have to do something very good.
What is it? I'll do anything.
We can't tell you. And the mermaids dove into the water and they started to swim away. And the whale dove up in the air and came down with its mighty tail. Splash! Got John soaking wet. Well, John, he walked along that sandy beach until he came to a field. It was a hilly field, a long, long, open, hilly field. And he saw a little white spot way across the field, about the size of a golf ball. Well, Johnny ran across that field, and when he got there, it wasn't a golf ball at all. It was a furry little bunny. Hi, bunny, said John.
Ooh, you startled me, said the bunny. You startled me. I'm lost, Johnny. I'm lost. I've really done it to myself this time. I'll never find my way home, Johnny. I'm really lost now.
Well, wait a minute. Where do you live? Maybe I can help you find your way home.
You'll never be able to help me find my way home, John. You don't know where I live. I live in a field full of mushrooms, John. It's on the other side of a forest. You got to walk by a beach and across a field. You'll never know where I live, John.
Come on. I know where you live. I'll bring you there. And John scooped up that bunny and cradled it in his arms. And John walked back across that field. And he walked along the beach. He looked out in the water, and the whale was back on the surface of the water, and the mermaids were on the whale's back, braiding each other's hair, sort of winking at John. And then John, he walked into that forest, and the bear was still climbing the tree, trying to get the moon out the sky, because it messed with his sleep at night. And then he walked into that field full of mushrooms, and he saw that little old man sitting on a tree stump with a long gray beard, had on Oshkosh jeans and Reeboks, and right next to the tree was a mother bunny. And John said, "Excuse me, Miss Bunny, is this your baby?" "Indeed it is, Johnny, indeed it is. Whoopee!" And the mother bunny ran over and squeezed that little baby. "Ooh, ooh, 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 ooh." "Excuse me, Mother Bunny, but do you know where the snail with the silver shell lives?" "Oh, yes, John. You go right down that path over there, John. You step over a log. You turn around three times. You take three steps to your left, three steps to your right. Turn around again, and you'll be facing a wall, John. John, when you face that wall, say, 'Buzz, buzz, once there was.' And John, that wall will open up. And there'll be a long corridor. You walk down that corridor, John. The snail lives down there. But John, be very careful, because down there lives a fire-breathing dragon. Would you like a salad?" But John was already gone. He went down the path. He stepped over a log. He turned around three times. He took three steps to his left, three steps to his right, turned around once again. He was facing a wall, and he said, "Buzz, buzz, once there was," and that wall started to open up, and there was a long corridor, and John started to walk down that corridor, trying to be as quiet as possible, when all of a sudden, out of nowhere, came a fire breathing dragon. "Ah, John, I'm gonna eat you up, John. Ah."
"Whoa, whoa, 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 don't eat me up. I'm looking for the snail with the silver shell. He told me 100 stories. I don't know anymore. My friends think I'm boring. I need some more stories."
"I know that snail, John. He told me 100 stories too, but he won't tell me anymore, John. I'm gonna eat him up too. But first, I'm gonna eat you up.
Arr. Would you eat me if I told you 50 stories?"
"Definitely."
"Arr. Would you eat me if I told you 75 stories?"
"Yes."
"Arr. Would you eat me if I told you 100 stories?"
"Maybe. Maybe not." And John told that fire-breathing dragon 100 stories.
"Hey, John, you're all right. I was only fooling about that eating up bot. The snail's right around the corner there. Go ahead."
And John walked around the corner, and there was a snail. And John said, "Oh, snail, I'm so glad I found you. Listen, I told your stories to my friends. They really liked them a lot. But now I don't know any more stories, and they think I'm boring. Can you tell me some more stories, huh?"
And the snail looked at John and said, "John, I told you all the stories that I know. I don't know any more stories, John. John, you have to make up your own."
"My own?"
"Yes, John, your own."
"My own? My own? My own?"
Just then, a bumblebee flew through the air over to John's ear and said, "Buzz, buzz, once there was a little boy whose name was John." And John opened his eyes just in time to hear his mother's voice come floating by. "John, John!" It was supper time. John's stomach was grumbling. John looked around. He hadn't been anywhere. John was dreaming. And John got up and he ran all the way home and he had a nice big supper. And after supper, he sat on the porch and his friends came over and they sat on the steps and on the banister and on the lawn. And they were all sitting around
And you know what they say in the summertime. There's nothing to do. It's boring. There's nothing to do. And they looked at John and said, hey, John, do you know any stories? And John said, no, I don't know any stories. I told you all the stories that I know. I don't know any more stories. You don't know any more stories? John is boring. John is boring. Just then, a bumblebee flew through the air over to John's ear and said, buzz, buzz, once there was a little boy whose name was John. And John said, hey, wait, I do know a story. Hey, everybody, John knows a story. Go ahead, Johnny, we're with you. Go, Johnny. And Johnny said, well, once there was a witch about the size of a gummy bear. She taught magic tricks to all the worms, how to dig holes in the ground and come up with little pebbles. Then he told a story about a man in a field full of mushrooms and how those mushrooms used to be stories, but the man didn't share them with anyone and they all turned into mushrooms. And then he told a story about a bear climbing a tree, trying to get the moon out the sky because it messed with his sleep at night. And then he told a story about a dozen mermaids on the back of a whale and how they braided each other's hair. And then he told a story about a lost bunny and how happy the mother bunny was to have her baby back home. And then he told a story about a cave. And he told a story about a fire-breathing dragon. And whenever John told stories after story and after story, and whenever John ever almost ran out of stories, it never failed. A bumblebee would float through the air over to John's ear and say, buzz, buzz, once there was.